Okay guys, so a little update. I've done a bit of hatch work. This is the hatch kind of finished underneath. Just got to drill the holes through, but that is now pieced on there, added on. Fits in there lovely jubbly. So I decided to add an extra little piece on the back and around so that the hatch isn't sticking up past the lip of the board. So once the seal's in, it should be sort of more or less flush. If it's up a little bit, no problem. But before, without this extra piece, it was sticking up a little bit too much. So I took the time, added some foam, and just in the process of some light spackle filler around, just to mold that in, blend that in. And then I'll carbon that, and that'll all match in then with the hatch. Sorry for the shaky camera, I haven't got a stabilizer. Oh yeah, I've got the board indoors, so you know, if you're single, you can get away with working in the indoors in the lounge when the weather's bad. But yeah, if you're married or got a girlfriend, you'll understand that you probably won't be able to do that. So there you go. Okay guys, a little shot of a bit of work I've been doing on the backside here. I've just cut this piece off. It was coming out straight. I want a nice ramp so I can put these two outlet pipes, the water outlets, onto here with a 3D printed kind of bracket. So I've got a bit more room now to put them on there, and they're sticking up a little bit higher. And then where the old outlets came, or the inlets, sorry, from the nozzles, I filled those holes. So now, bit of carbon over all this, and I'll give you a shot of that when that's done. Okay guys, here's a little shot. Got the drives kind of in there, well they are in there, bolted up. I've taken a drill bit now, and that little white speck there is a dot where I've drilled through. Well, I haven't drilled through, with my fingers gone in all the holes, and I'm gonna whip them out now and drill through. So I just thought I'd give you a shot at it with the drives in. Looks tidy, eh? Clean. Okay guys, all right, I've got the hole make it happener here. I'm gonna drill through. There's obviously the foam in the middle, so I've got to drill the first top layer here, and then that one there. So you go through the foam, and then you've got the keeper straight up and down. Starting with a small drill bit, obviously, just to get me going. All right, they're going through easy peas. I'll get all those drilled out and I'll be back. We're all drilled through. I've opened them up to sort of 5 mil, and I've countersunk down with a spade drill. That's kind of all I had, but it's about the right size. And then you know, I've got these hex head nuts, bolts, and they're gonna go in there. With the carbon, I'm going to mix up a bit of carbon strand in the resin. I've gone right down to the first layer underneath, so I've got no foam in between, so I can get a good, you know, a good bite without it squashing anything. So this will just be filled now with a bit of carbon strand mixed with a bit of epoxy, and I'll probably push these in to get me a divot so that they sit flush at the end. So that'll look kind of cool. There's a lot of screws. But once they're done and all, you know, you won't really know. So hopefully they're long enough. I bought sort of different size these, and then a shorter set. But I'll see that once I get the drives in and start bolting up. There we go, guys. So I'll be back. I'm going to mix up a bit of carbon strand, clean these a little bit more. Fins in the way a little bit, I found. But once that comes off one day, and I'll have to try and make a small fin box or something that fits in here, a slim line, because one day these will be coming off, and I'll be the next step really. Once I've tested everything, the drives, I want these removable. So it's basically going to be a bit of a kit, you know, and if I can eventually get these molded, and I want to kind of start selling, if I can sell a board with the drives and everything, you know, as a kit, I thought that would be quite a cool little deal. So we're carrying on, and I'll be back with more. Okay, Waysiders, here we are at the end of all things. I've done everything. I've spent hours, obviously. That's why these videos take a while, because it's a lot of carbon. Drying, sanding, finishing, trying, you know, the drives, getting those in. Some of the holes were off. God knows how they got off, like, so bad, but they were. Anyway, I've just rested these in here, little motors, just to see if they're, you know, supporting nice. And it all seems at the minute like it's all lining up. I won't know until I get my prop put in there and the coupler in, and just tire it all in properly, you know. But they're in. I can mess with that now. So I've redone inside the base here. I've redone the bulkhead flat as I can go. The bottom base was also flattened, which actually turned out pretty nice. But as I'm tightening, the 5mm foam in between is collapsing slightly. So eventually I need to really tighten that more, 2-3 layers. The final version of the board will obviously have a thicker carbon, you know, sandwiched it now. There's all the countersunk holes. These took a while, you know, and some were kind of slightly off out of position, but all it's done is basically pulled, as it's pulled down, I've got some dimples around, you know, the bolts. So they're dimpling in, which isn't a big deal. It's really for the gasket inside now. You know, this gasket I've put round inside, if that's now, you know, not flat, I shouldn't get any leaking. I feel like it's pulled up, you know, enough. But that's basically the bottom side, all kind of done and fitting now. I just had to elongate some of the holes a little bit and get the screws fitting more straight than, you know, if they're at an angle going into the nut, it's not going to capture the nut properly. So anyway, they're all fitting. The back rear piece is done. That's all good. I'll give you a shot of the hatch after now. But basically, from now on, I can fit the middle tunnel piece, the capacitor bank holders that go in the side up the front here, get the wiring done, you know, and start to piece back together some of the electronics and get my head back around how that works again. It's been a while now, it's been a year or so since I rode the board. So get it all back installed, everything tested. I've got to put the hatch on now with the seal again and go down first, number one, for a dunk test. Make sure the hatches are sealing and that nothing's coming out through these drives here. Number one thing is the water. No water in is beautiful. And there you go, guys. This is gonna be the end of this video. I'll give you a shot round with the hand held so you can see a little bit different angles. But I'll see you on the next one, Waysiders. You keep it raw, keep it real, keep it wriggling. And we'll be back for more. This will be running, get it whirling like it used to. But she will get molded. I want this as a plug, and I can do more on it before I mold it. You know, I can really rip into it and make things smooth and perfect. So this is basically test board version, sort of 1.2.0.3.7, and lots of work, guys. I mean, it's a project. You know, stick with me because there's always more. I won't let you down. Enough waffle. I'll see you on the next video, guys. Hit them buttons for me. Lovely jubbly. See you later.